Hi, Phyllis Moore here, Philosophically Speaking. Please click like, share, and subscribe, or subscribe, whatever, all of the above, comment, all that good stuff, and kind of tag along on this two-way conversation, I hope, even though right now you're just hearing me. But got a few words of wisdom, just nuggets to just throw out there like seeds I'm going to scatter everywhere. I'm thinking of that song. Oh gosh, who sang it? Don't turn around. I'm not going to sing it. That would be rude. And then you'll never click like, share, or subscribe. Well, you might share because you're going, can you believe this woman tried to sing? How awful. Don't turn around. Oh, the commissar's in town. You know, words that are like, what? What do those lyrics even mean? Well, I don't need to know. It's fine. But I'm thinking of that because the sentiment of don't turn around, you know, keep going. Look at the future. You know, if you think about a car, you have the tiny side mirrors, you have the, you know, the back window, the front windshield, you know, and the rear view mirror. If you look at all of those, the rear view mirror is smaller than the windshield ahead of you. That's because you don't need to go back. We've already been there. You need to go forward. You need to go to the future. Back to the future. No, I'm sorry, that's a movie title. But you need to keep moving in the right direction. Don't go back and repeat past mistakes. You can't undo them. You can't fix them. The best you can hope for is to have attained wisdom and peace and forgiveness for yourself, for other people. You do the best that you can. You know, I know that the Bible always preaches forgiveness, and that is a great thing to have, to give, to do, but sometimes people won't let you forget, or they won't accept your forgiveness, or they don't forgive you. And sometimes you just have to let go of that rope. If we look at this as one big tug of war, my rule of thumb is let go. Let go of that rope inside your own personal internal boundaries. Because if other people want to hold on to anger, resentment, meanness, unforgiveness, you know, whatever those negative, toxic emotions are, okay, sometimes you just can't help people. You just have to let go of it, and they may not even realize you've let go of the rope, and they're still holding on to it tightly. Okay, let them. But we are on a time-dated, time limit of life, because we only are here for that amount of existence, and then we are no longer here. So as long as you inhabit your body, as long as you can draw breath and open your eyes each day, yeah, live it to the very fullest. It doesn't make you selfish, doesn't make you discompassionate. You just have to know where the hard ground is and where the soft ground is for you to scatter the seeds of hopefully kindness and goodness, and not just, reiterating all kinds of wrongs and things and repeating bad patterns. So again, back to the sentiment of moving forward and trying to live, okay, I don't want to be quirky here, but live your best life, be the best version of yourself. I know that that's probably like rhetoric to some of you, but yeah, be the best possible you that you can. I mean, that's all you get to do, is to hopefully become someone that you like, someone that you respect, someone that you admire. You know, I mean, we shouldn't be comparing ourselves to someone else, but we certainly shouldn't be thinking we're less than, or we limit ourselves, you know, because if we are not a fan of ourselves, and if we do not believe in, you know, yourself, myself, you know, who you are, well, who else is going to? And maybe that'll happen, but it's so much better if you're the first in line to have faith in what you are capable of. Bet on yourself. You know, take a chance on you. And if you do, maybe, well, I would believe others will as well. But, you know, if you do look at that sentiment of, you know, don't keep looking back. You've already been there. You know, now go into the unknown. And take that leap of faith. It's a really, really good thing. So my words of wisdom today, stay the course, stay in your lane, don't give up. Tomorrow is a new day. Every day is a brand new day. And you get not a do-over, because we don't get to repeat these days, but we certainly get to repeat our efforts. And if you replicate them, Hopefully it will not be like the movie Groundhog Day, where you just kept doing it the same thing over and over and over. Some of the circumstances kept being repeated in that script. But if you remember the movie, every day he tried to tweak it and do a little bit better. Well, fortunately, we don't have to live the same thing over and over again. But it might not be, you know, the same exact day, February 2nd, Groundhog Day. But every day you get a chance to be better, do better, think better, act better. Don't stay stuck. Do not think this is the best you can ever be. I guarantee you, if you try some new muscles and you make an attempt and an effort, you will be amazed at what you're capable of. So give yourself permission to do that. Stay the course. Hang in there. Keep trying. And maybe, well, I believe. I'm not going to say maybe. The quality of your life will improve as you improve upon yourself. Please be safe out there. Enjoy your day. Don't forget to click like, share, and subscribe, and we'll catch up more later. Bye.